Good morning, Hoover Elementary. Dr. G here on Hawk TV, wishing you all a very happy Wednesday and a happy college and career day. At this time, please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. At this time, please remain standing for a brief moment of silence. Thank you. You may be seated.
All right, everybody. Good to see you. Did everybody get a chance to see the Blue Angels and the Thunderbirds fly over yesterday? I stood outside and the sky was blue, but unfortunately, I wasn't able to see them. They didn't fly over my house. My brother lives about a half hour from me, and he said he couldn't see them, but he could hear them. So I'm very interested to hear from you guys whether you could see the Blue Angels and the Thunderbirds. That's great that they did that for all of our COVID-19 responders. We appreciate that. And like I said, it's College and Career Day. If you want to go to Harvard University, or if you want to go to Delaware State, if you really want to go anywhere, you got to work hard. You got to do your best. You can't give up. And you got to do your work in Canvas, okay? So let's make sure that that happens. All right, got my schedule here. Dun, dun, dun. It's April 29th, 2020. And like I said, it is College and Career Day. It's a great time to kind of reflect on what are you going to do with your life? What are you going to be when you grow up? What job are you going to try and prepare for? What college is going to work for you? Someplace that's online, a state school, a big state school, a private college that, you know, maybe is part of the Ivy League. What do you need to do to get there? I bet if you talk to your parents, you could find out a little bit more. You might want to research. Maybe you got an older brother or sister who's getting ready for the college application process. And, you know, sometimes these colleges, they ask for letters of recommendation, even from your kindergarten teacher. They'll say, you know, how were they on Canvas? Did they work hard? Were they respectful? Were they responsible? Were they safe? You might want to find out about that. All right, we got some birthdays today. Hayden B., happy birthday to Hayden B. We wish you all the best today. Hope you have a great birthday. Also, a big congratulations to Dr. McGee. The Board of Education last night appointed Dr. McGee as our new superintendent in Neshaminy. He's going to start his job, I think, July 1st. Dr. McGee has spent a number of years here in Neshaminy. He actually graduated from Maple Point High School. Who knew? I thought Maple Point was a middle school. He graduated from Maple Point High School, and he was a math teacher at Neshaminy High School, and he was an assistant principal and a principal at Neshaminy High School. He's been the director of secondary ed for a while, and now he's going to be our superintendent. And many of you Hoover Hawks know Dr. McGee because sometimes when things are a little hectic or things are a little crazy, like we have a crazy snowstorm or something like that, he usually comes over to Hoover and he helps us out. So he does a great job. He's an honorary Hoover Hawk, and we wish him well in his new position. Canvas, like I said, no matter where you're going, whether you're going to get a job in the job market, you're going to be in the military, you're going to go to a state school, a two-year school, a four-year school, or a private school, you got to do your work, all right? It's not so much about it's required. It's your job. You need to learn something, all right? And your teachers have worked so hard to make these lessons fun and engaging and to make sure that they're going to help you learn what you need to know so you could one day go to Harvard or Delaware State or wherever. All right, so don't forget, spend at least 30 minutes in ELA, 30 minutes in math, 30 minutes in science, 30 minutes in social studies, 30 minutes specials. Take plenty of breaks, all right? And I know we've had a couple of issues. Remember, you usually can't move forward if you haven't completed something. So if you're stuck, don't get frustrated. Just try and problem solve. Think, is this an internet issue? Because, you know, the whole world is doing what we're doing now. There are certain times of the day when I think every kid in the world and every parent is trying to do Zoom meetings. And that just slows down the internet a little bit. So you might want to figure out a time, you know, maybe set your alarm, try and get up before noon or something, and see if you can do some of this stuff earlier than the other kids. The early bird gets the worm, all right? I find that sometimes I can get a lot done early in the morning or in the afternoon or evening. Sometimes right in the middle of the day, things slow down a little bit. That's just frustrating. If you do get stuck, you can reach out to your teacher. Your teacher can help you. If for some reason you just think, you know what, I'm done for right now with that lesson, you can stop and then you can try a different lesson. And then if you're done after 3 hours, just send an email to your teacher. Look, we did our best. We spent 3 hours and now we're going to do something else. Okay. But it's really important that we get this stuff in. And it's important that you make this fun. Okay. So think of ways to make it fun. Throw in some breaks. Maybe give yourself a little chart and check things off. And when you get things done, maybe give yourself a little reward. Maybe you get to spend a little time with a video game or a little time going for a walk or playing baseball, whatever you do. Also, don't forget, next week is Teacher Appreciation Week. And boy, we need to really appreciate our teachers. They are working really hard day and night, weekends, trying to make sure everything's nice for our kids. So think of some things you could do next week. Maybe send an email to your teacher, thanking your teacher for all of their hard work. Maybe one of your teachers now is your mom or your dad. Maybe you're going to think of a way to send them a thank you note for all of their hard work in helping you. Maybe you're going to send a thank you note to somebody you've had in the past who's been a teacher. Maybe you've learned something really important from someone who's not even a traditional teacher. Maybe your grandfather taught you how to fish, and maybe you really appreciate the fact that they did that. So maybe you'll write him a thank you letter. So think of those things. I think we'll have a great Teacher Appreciation Week. I know we're going to have a fun day on Canvas. You know, it just seems like every day Canvas is getting a little better. Our kids are getting a little more familiar with how it works. And our parents are getting a little bit better. It's like it's all coming together. And that just makes me happy.
Everything is great. Everything is grand. Got the whole wide world in the palm of my hand.
Everything is perfect. It's falling into place. I can't seem to wipe this smile off my face. Life's a happy song. And there's someone by my side to sing along. When you're alone, life can be a little low. It makes you feel like you're 3 foot tall. When it's just you, the times can be tough. When there's no one there to catch your fall. Everything is great, everything is grand. I got the whole wide world in the palm of my hand. Everything is perfect, it's falling into place. I can't seem to wipe this smile off my face. Life smells like a rose.
Everything is perfect. Everything is grand. Everything's falling into place on Canvas. Have a great day, everybody. Enjoy your college and career day. Think about where you're going to go to school one day and how you're going to get there. Take care.